Welcome to Stereo 3D Productions and this virtual reality let's play of Fallout 4 using Vorpex to power the VR and now experimenting with the Oculus Rift CV1 as the VR headset. Yeah, that's right. Some of you people may have watched the last part and now be wondering why the hell I ended up rushing to the Oculus Rift CV1 much faster than I initially said I would. Well, it's called motivation. A lot of people have actually been watching my Fallout videos since I started posting them. Thank you for that. And someone left a comment on one of the videos in the series. His name is Kit Havoc. And he was asking about Oculus Rift CV1 settings, and initially I gave the warning as a reply that the Vive settings wouldn't work very well with the CV1 because the CV1 has a much tighter horizontal field of view, and thus what I have for the Vive might be way too much for the CV1. You'd basically get too much image on your screen. And then I got curious. After I gave that reply, I legitimately got curious on if I was correct or not. So I fired up the game using my Vive settings, but with the Oculus Rift CV1 through Vorpex. And wow, holy vertical field of view, Batman. That's what I can say. I'm seeing black edges on the right and left of my view, much more than I do with the Vive. With the Vive, I'm getting that legit human FOV more than that. So with the Rift, you can kind of see your feet. It's sort of the way I could explain it. Whereas with the Vive, you almost see your fucking ears. So each headset right now is showing very different properties. You wouldn't think this is the case for hardware that is built with the same damn displays, but there you go. They're completely different. Before I go ahead and tell you how wonderful it looks and how it's gonna play and everything, I gotta go through the settings. Time for a settings overhaul. So let's imagine that we're running Fallout 4 for the very first time ever and we're doing it in virtual reality. First thing you wanna do, obviously, is run the game at least once. So you go ahead and do that and the launcher comes up and it wants to detect your graphics settings. Like I've been saying with the Vive, whatever it's gonna take is probably gonna be much too high for VR. It's going to be fine for your screen in 2D, but it will not run well in VR because the settings will be way too high. The settings are too damn high. So what you want to do is first and foremost, lower all your graphics settings. Start with the lowest possible baseline, work your way up from there. Don't start too high and work your way down. The first of two methods will work much faster, will get you to something that is playable much quicker. So that's what you want to do first. My graphics settings would show you that I have everything on medium, something slightly above medium, the distant detail, the object fade and stuff like that. But I really took a cautious approach because I know that VR is pretty beefy on the system. It's pretty demanding. The next thing you want to do at that point is open the Vorpex configurator. And you run its settings optimizer. So you go to the game settings optimizer and you pick the Fallout 4 profile. Leave everything checked on for now. We'll get to the resolution after. What you want to do is you want to change that field of view it's suggesting to 115. 115, not 125 like I had it for the Vive. So 115 on the field of view. You take the default resolution, you apply the other things. Hey, buddy. And you run the optimization. It's going to confirm to you that it's done so. At that point, you can go ahead and head on to the INI files of your game if you wish to increase the resolution. There are three resolutions that should work with these settings. So you got three options. This is the easiest way to scale the performance to your GPU, meaning if it's running too slow, do this first, lower the resolution first. The lowest resolution you can run at is 1280 by 1024. It'll look okay. The second resolution you can run at is 1368 by 1080. It's an experimental resolution. It is not ideal. It will give you more amount of detail in your display, but the God rays will have a sort of square pattern in them. It does cause some graphical issues with the game. So I don't necessarily recommend the resolution, but if you do find 1280 by 1024 to be too low, do by all means try that one. Last but not least is the 1600 by 1200 resolution, which I am using right now because, oh god, the game looks so fucking great. So here's how you put your resolution. Anyone who has used the Vorpex settings optimizer to do your thing in the previous step, you need to do this additional step as well because the resolutions are all wrong. You open the INI file, the preferences INI file, which I'll show the path on your screen right now. And you go in there and you change the resolution to, if you're going for 1280 by 1024, you're gonna put in 1279 by 1023. If you're going by 1368 by 1080, you're gonna put 1367 by 1079. And last but not least, if you're going for 1600 by 1200, you're gonna put 1599 by 1199. Why, you ask? Yeah, he's asking why too. Look, you saw the look he gave me. He's like, what the fuck are you doing? There's a lockpick bug in this game. You get to a fucking lockpick. If you have an even resolution number for some fucked up reason, you can't see the lockpicking. Yeah. So that's why you have to remove one unit on each dimension of your resolution. So we're done with the resolution of the resolution. Let's call it that, because it's a problem resolution of the graphics resolution. So it's time to fire up the game. That's right. You go in the game, you start a new game, make it to the house, get past all the fucking movies, all that shit. Make it to the house where you are free to move about. Do not proceed with the story, because what you're going to want to do is be able to stand somewhere uninterrupted and open the Vorpex HUD. You press the delete key that brings up your HUD. Let's go to the main settings here. 3D reconstruction on geometry, that's one of the most fucking important things. If you don't put geometry, you will not feel like you are inside this game. Separation strength, 0.6. This is where it gets similar to my other settings, my Vive settings. 0.6 seems to be the key setting in this game. The rest you leave untouched. HUD scale, 0.55 is pushing that shit in well within my view. I can read everything so far. The rest is on default. G3D shadow treatment must be on turn off, otherwise you will have some unpleasant artifacts in your view. Image zoom, I am at the low end of 0.87, so meaning if I go to 0.88 here, I press once, twice, and I stop there, because if I press again, I go to 0.86, right? I'm at the low end of 0.87, and then I have my full-size mirror window to capture this, which I'll talk about in a second very quickly. Head tracking sensitivity stays on default at 0.6, a pretty good one. My disable mouse acceleration is set to on, and that is it. You are set to play Fallout 4 with the Oculus Rift CV1. Now there's another thing. You remember the known issue where the game bugs out after half an hour? Well, I'm very curious to find out if it'll be the case with the Oculus Rift CV1. Maybe, for some fucked up reason, this only happens with the Vive. I don't know yet. We will find out. Now, I actually do hope that the bug only happens with the Vive, believe it or not, even though I plan on returning to the Vive. I do hope the bug doesn't happen here, and I'll tell you why. It's because setting up the capture, the video capture with OBS and Vorpex is a pain in the ass with the Oculus Rift CV1. I'm capturing the full frame output right now, which is 2160 by 1200, using the same GPU that's running the game. I'm capturing it with the chromatic aberration in there, so the video probably will most definitely not look as good as my Vive video, which is captured without the image distortions. And also, if anything were to happen during my gameplay, unlike with Steam VR, where I use its common mirror window, which basically the runtimes handle the mirror image, and then the game handles itself. In this case, I'm using Vorpex's mirror image, which, if my game crashes, the mirror image goes with it. Well, it doesn't crash, but I need to restart it, right? And that means I will need to close the Vorpex window, and that means I'll need to reset my capture every goddamn half hour. Now, it's time to play this game, and what I did is I didn't even restart Fallout 4, so as to let the time tick on and see if I will reach that point where the game just fucking freaks out and starts running at 5 frames per second. I want to push it in that direction. Meanwhile, it's time to do something cool. I want to try it out full-hearted with the Oculus Rift. Note on the VR cover, I did 2 mods since I last used it for Euro Truck Simulator. One of them was to attempt to fix the nose port. It really doesn't work. Well, I had to actually cut off the piece that goes through the nose port. Because it's just always flailing around over your nose, and it actually worsens the problem that the Oculus Rift has, where the fabric sort of rubs on your nose already inside the headset and tickles it. I find it fucking infuriatingly annoying. And the other problem is... So, wait a minute. Hang on. I gotta think here. Concord... Okay. Come on, boy. Come on. We're gonna go this way. And the... well, the problem is that the VR cover's nose port section keeps basically going down on your nose and just fucking lightly rubbing it, and it caused the exact same problem is the fabric of the Rift itself. So I took it off, and I also added a Velcro mod on the top head strap so that it would stop slipping up, and that holds it in place nicely now. I want to go far from home with my dog and spend some time alone, because I've been put through the test. And my mind is put to rest. And I'm going on a psycho holiday. That's right, folks. We're going on a psycho holiday. I remember going to a place that I visited once. It wasn't too nice to me. I sort of wanted to go pay him a visit and just say hi. Oh, that feels so... oh, yeah. Holy shit. Actually, fucking... Wait, let's go, man. That feels good. Where is he? Where is he? Where are you? Funny guy. Come on back. Did you despawn there or something? Did you despawn? I don't even know how long I've been playing. It is feeling great in here. I haven't spoken of how it looks yet, so here we go. The game looks actually pretty freaking good in the Oculus Rift CV1. However, this is one of these rare first times where I could tell you that the game distinctly and most definitely looks better in the HTC Vive. I couldn't always say that for all VR games. A lot of VR games with the need for distant detail look better in the Oculus Rift because of the Fresnel lenses. However, for some fucked up reason, I can't quite tell you why, I just can't, to my great surprise, get the edges in the graphics looking as good as they did with the Vive, which would be normally the exact fucking opposite. with most VR experiences, you require more super sampling with the Vive than you do with the Oculus Rift. Alright, folks. Where are you? Funny guy. Come on, boy. There he is. I have some friends out there I haven't seen in a while. I just want to go and say hi. I sort of forget the layout. I haven't been here in a really long time, so. Now I'm far from home, spending time alone. It's time to set my evil free! Been put to the test, my mind laid to rest. Shut up. I'm on a psycho holiday! Yeah! Alright, what I have to do now is get away. Here's the problem with this place is that they're so receptive that they will get you in serious deals of trouble. But what I wanted to do is sort of slowly come in. Now, I think I can't run right now, and I don't know how long this lasts, and I missed the queue because I guess it's gone? Things that are told to you in the middle of battle are not cool. That's not cool. Can I go up to 2? Yes. Can I go up to 3? No. Okay. That's not cool. Telling me shit in the middle of battle. I like when the flow can continue. However, my pitch is correct. It doesn't feel wrong. And I have to be extremely fucking careful. I fucked up on the second raider. You miss one shot and that's what happens. Because I know that there are even stronger raiders. After. If I switch, I need to switch back. I'm gonna stay with this because it has more ammo. One thing I can tell you is the difference with the Oculus Rift. It's not necessarily that the edges are worse, it's that they're even all the way through. Far is as good as near. Whereas with the Vive, I would say that it degrades. I can see him. It degrades as you go. You know, the further the detail is, the less well you see it. Doesn't even know I'm fucking here, does he? Oh shit, yeah he does. Right, quickly. Where is there? There we go. Hurry. See, drawing them out is probably the better idea here. Now I'm very scared of stepping in further yet because over here, you can't kill enough of them. They're still gonna come. I remember this. I'm trying to at least fucking get some rounds out of them or some flip lighter. What the fuck is a ghoul doing with a flip lighter? So as you can see, it's just fucking taking a much more careful approach than I did the first time I came here. I wanted to do some shooting with the Oculus Rift right away. That's the first thing I wanted to do. Most important thing, look, I know that 99% of the gameplay in this game is actually not shooting, okay? I was kind of joking when I said that earlier, but the most important mechanic to have function properly is the shooting. It can actually so bitter up a play that is otherwise filled with coolness. So I really, really wanted to get that shit down right away. And this is probably the worst place to go to for me because I remember having serious fucking problems coming here. Fuse. Ew. Did I
No way, I didn't kill this guy. Did I? Oh, shit, man. It's just everywhere you go, there's another one. I'm gonna wait for him. Let's see what I got in. Oh, wait a minute. No. Dog pound, no, shut up. Okay, there we go. You tap R to reload. No, don't send me in there. The fucking ghoul just went in there, you idiot. I'm not going there. Hang on. I do there? Why can't I fucking move? Oh, I'm encumbered. Oh, shit. I'm encumbered. Time to drop some shit. Okay. That helps. Oh, I'm moving actually much faster than I did so far in the game. Where did he go? Where the fuck did he... I fucking hate when I lose track of my adversary. And now I know there's more ghouls in those cement blocks. I'm not going up there, game. I'm fucking not going up there. I will, however, get curious about this. I can see outside, and it's unbelievably... Like I said, it's not a lack of clarity. Because right now, I'm using excellent clarity to see outside. It's that everything's even. It's just the edges aren't quite perfect, and they're not quite perfect the whole way through. Foreground, background, everything. But it does look very good. Don't get me wrong here. Don't think that I'm, like, trashing the game or anything. This is absolutely not the case. There's some dynamic shadows here. This is an example of those shadows that render anyways. Even though I have the thing on turn off, it goes ahead and renders that shadow anyways. Where did it go? That fucking bothers me so much. They wander interestingly. I don't know if they despawn. That would be lame. Make sure also not to get blindsided by one. Oh, there he is. Did they just fucking die? Like, just drop dead or something? Yeah, he's just wandering off. You're not necessarily obliged to confront in this game. It's pretty interesting. But it was a pretty fruitful run. What I figured if I came back here is just use that little house as a sort of fallback position. I know I have to reset my pitch right now. It's all weird. Yeah, there we go. There we go. So far, I'm impressed since I've put... Oh, this is something I kind of forgot in my settings overhaul. I am still using the two same mods that I use for the HTC Vive. The no DOF mod and the no recoil mods. They're kind of essential to VR because the recoil will move your mouse pitch and that will fuck you up. You'll end up basically playing the game like this after 2 minutes. Like you're looking almost straight down to look forward. And that's extremely annoying. It's not a way you want to play a VR game. And the other thing is the other note is that I am using my pitch-locked mouse. I'm using a mouse that does not respond vertically in order to keep my level view. It does require the eventual adjustment, but it's by all means very manageable and does improve the experience a great deal. Wow. The Fallen Bridge is pretty amazing. Oh, look at this. This is a fucking mess. This is a fucking mess. I have an idea, though. I may be able to have a little bit of fun with these guys. while keeping it somewhat careful. Can I do this? Yes. Come here. Come here, buddy. No, not my dog. Not my dog. I hate this gun. I officially hate this gun. Okay. I officially hate that fucking thing. I am point blank shooting the guy. Point blank fucking shooting the guy. Does nothing. Oh shit! Got stuck on something. There we go. Ah shit. Oh no! Bad, 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 bad! Hey! Bro, I saved! I don't remember. Okay, first and fucking foremost, I'll do exactly what I wanted to do here. No. That's exactly not what I wanted to do. Is not use a gun that's shit is going to be the first thing I need to do. What'd you find, boy? That's the one thing I didn't check. Folder. Maybe there's something important in there? Battered clipboard. Desk. Loading dock terminal. Welcome to Robco Industries Termlink, Bedford Station, loading dock. Cargo regulations. Bedford Station Cargo Regulations, Policy Revision 4.3-521-77. All cargo manifests are to be logged to this terminal. Logs will be maintained locally for 6 months before being archived to holotape. Intake shipments occur between 8 and 8:30. Delivery to the quarry is expected no later than 12, no exceptions. Output shipments occur between 15 and 17 hours. 1700 hours. Cargo designated 0000 miscellaneous should be forwarded to the quarry. Notify foreman Lanham upon arrival for further instructions. View cargo manifests. BML drill parts. Trying to see if maybe it's going to hint me to any very valuable items. Intake. Grades on steel rebar, 4 pallets, fastening, 1 bulk crate, electrical wire, 24 spools. Huh. That's interesting. You know what's cool, dog? I got a gun that's not shit. It just went to fucking hell. Right there. That shit just went fucking straight to hell. I'm standing there and I bumped into something while backing up because I completely lost my reference while changing weapons. I need to learn how to use the keys to change weapons. I understand that. Right now, I really, really got beyond fucked. Yeah. This is what I wanted to do. Gotta get the fuck out of the way after you kill something, then come back. You sort of give it a sort of cooldown period. I know my pitch is wrong right now. I want to readjust it, but I want to do one of these first. I need some ammo. Flip lighter. Fuck you, flip lighter. Is that the flip lighter carrier from earlier? So does that mean that the other ghoul... Fuck, I almost lost my bearings again. Come on, Doc. I need to see if that brown-gray one, okay, there he is. Okay, cool. There's a much stronger, quicker one that I saw. This guy. The roamer. Oh, shit, there's another one there. All right, cool. Whoa, wait, what? Is the fucking dog is fighting it? Holy shit. Oh, way too many, way too many. Retreat, retreat, retreat. Holy shit, I like the stamina in this game. Oh, fuck, are you serious? Are you fucking serious? Are you fucking serious? Are they chasing me? Where's my fucking dog? Holy fuck, game! Shit. Oh, they are on me, man. Holy shit. What's that? There's a cooking pot over there, but holy shit. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Gotta take care of him. There you are. I gotta save this one. I actually... Impressive! Okay, that ghoul is sorta in stupid mode over there. And this one's coming up the road. I'm trying to sneak up. Oh, bullshit. Where's the other one? All right, there's the other one. Nice! Good job! Here. Good fucking job, boy! Ladies and gentlemen, I'm almost ready to declare that the bug only occurs with SteamVR. I can probably play this game perpetually with the Oculus Rift. That sucks actually a little bit because my favorite headset is the HTC Vive out of the two. But still, the plot thickens, ladies and gentlemen. That's all I can say. The plot thickens. How many took me on is the question. Yeah, the distant detail, even though I said like there's a difference in the way they're handling edges, each headset, the edges, the graphics, in each, I can tell you that you can see really, really, really far, especially the resolution of 1600 by 1200. You can see really fucking far, and thus you can, this is just like being inside Fallout. Minus a few tiny things, but the hindrances in the graphics do not impact your ability to see far. Crosshair. There's a piece of bridge in the extreme distance. It's so far that it has no more 3D depth. I gotta make sure not to get blindsided while I do this. It's so far that there's no more depth to it even. And I can tell that there's sort of things grown down from it, like kind of like weeds grown, that it's vines or something, but far, far, far. I'm talking behind the one I can see over there. So yeah, no, the distant detail, even though the edges aren't quite perfect, is really, really good. And this is the other thing. This is the only part so far I'm doing with the Oculus Rift CV1. I don't know if I'll do more. I will return to the HTC Vive for the next part. However, I'm open to doing more parts in order to improve these settings and see what may suit the Oculus Rift better or differently from the Vive. Because right now, my settings with the Vive are fucking so amazing. Like, I really was impressed at part 5 when I played how different it looked, how much better it looked. I'm trying to see if maybe Oculus's asynchronous time warp is hiding the fact that the game would be having any sort of heart attack. But no, this is running way too smoothly for the game to be running internally at like 5 or 10 frames per second right now. I'm almost ready to declare that it looks like the bug only happens with SteamVR. I'm looking at the dog's animation. This is looking like way more than 5 frames per second. Does this game use the microphone? Run. I no longer trust this game in terms of being able to get away from enemies. For fuck's sake, earlier I turned around and there's like two of them fucking taking me on full-heartedly. Like, it was a very brave effort from them. They gave me a good one. They didn't, like, for fuck's sake, the raptors in Ark will give up on you faster than these guys did. I was really impressed by that. Like, God, do you ever stop or do you just take on the chase? What a beautiful, full-hearted chase they took on. Okay, I'm doing something here. Every time I kill one, I want to keep record of this because we gotta sweep this area, man. Bedford Station, I think it's called. I want to clean up Bedford Station. Make Bedford Station great again. What does it take? Let's see what it takes. I know that we're already 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe 5 bodies down. Could have the count wrong. Could be up all the way up to 6 already. I hear ticking. You hear that ticking? You hear that ticking. Yeah, you too, eh? There's a tower over there. It looks like there's a lot of interesting things to discover here. It bothered me a lot when I came to explore this space that I had gotten my ass so owned without getting the chance to look around. And I do remember the game even giving me the discovered thing. Wow. Oh, what the fuck? Please tell me that's just the fire. I didn't see any other fucking ghouls. I'm not expecting any company. The heat haze effect is absolutely amazing. It might be a bit overdone. Like, you don't need that intense a heat haze effect. But I know what I'm going to try to do, because I remember the save game where I had discovered the station. I died after. So I'm trying to walk in far enough to discover it. Or maybe the discovers only happened once, even if you die and reload the game later on. I'm trying to fucking stick to the edges where I don't see any goddamn feral ghouls. The goddamn thing is, if you enter combat with one and then get two joining in, so a total of 3, you're fucked. You're fucked. Your dog can't keep one off while you're fighting the other. I know that there's one down there. I'm pretty sure I saw one. He was in, like, brain dead mode. But I will be extremely cautious here. I do want to take a look at the scenery. Drink it all in. This looks legitimate. This looks like 16K definition 3D 360 video. That being a very good thing, by the way. This is absolutely amazing. I'm sweeping my reticle in case I missed one and it's like in the bushes. The indicator is gonna pop up telling me I spotted a ghoul. We're gonna do a little rush in here. I know I'm not rushing, but we're rushing. Whoa, 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 whoa. I don't hear any battle music. Why did I fucking get shot at? Wow. Holy fuck. Look at this. Look at this. Look at it. Fucking look at it. That's the most fucking draw distance I've ever fucking seen in a game. Oh, there they are. Okay, so there's gunfighting going on. I probably don't want to go down that train track right away. I'm trying to look for ghouls from here, but I don't think the draw distance will allow me to spot them too easily. Crosshairs, there's something there. Lord Astahoff has been leaving comments on the channel. He's a good friend of mine. He actually lives in Montreal, is where I am. So we actually, in 2005 and 2006, we're actually jamming together on a regular basis. He plays guitar. Where the fuck are you, dog? The fuck are you? Is he in the house again? Where are you? I think it's the third time this happens to me, where the dog finds something and I take too long to notice where the dog is, and I don't see what he found. Where were you? Go! Show me! Damn it! You found something. You found what? What'd you find? What'd you find, boy? Tell me! Is this what you found? I know that now there's a cow down there carrying cargo. So there's someone cow back riding down there, and I can see also bullets traveling, so it's probably not a good idea for me to go down there yet. Let's go back home. It's the end of this psycho holiday, and we shall begin the trek back to more normal things. One thing I was hoping to find out here or somewhere, fucking carrots. Because now I know that back home, my objective right now is to grow crops. And for fuck's sake, carrots. Where do you find carrots in a place that's been so irradiated? I mean, I'm even trying to take a logical approach to it. God damn, these daytime graphics. Now, there's definitely more of an average degree of shimmer with the Oculus Rift. Now that the sun's really coming up, it's not as sharp. And I think I know why it's not as sharp. The only difference, really, and I'll play with the FOV to try to get there. So right now, yes, these settings are really good, but I'll probably improve them. I'll show you what needs to change. I need to reduce the FOV to something like 110. It'll increase the bars in the game, but it'll also allow me to reduce this number. And thus, what I'll be doing is I'll be taking a high-res image, crushing it down on the display even more. That value on the Vive is 0.8. On the Oculus Rift is 0.87. Which means the image is a little larger on the Oculus Rift, which in the end means that the edges are slightly stretched out and whatever flaws they have are more visible. So that's probably why it's happening. Oh, these are the ones I just fucking killed. Wow. That was fun, by the way. It was a lot of fun. Only died once, and I call bullshit on that. I massively called solid amounts of bullshit on that death. I'm telling you. That was complete bullshit. The laser musket is a fucking piece of shit, because I think it doesn't hit point blank, nor does it hit far range. It has this sort of, I'll hit 6 feet away, but I won't hit 3 feet away, nor 9 away. You have to be in the perfect distance. Fuck that shit. The shotgun has been actually really, really good for me. It's gotten me out of shit with the mosquitoes last time. Well, definitely something I want to check out. Oh, oh, oh shit. Did you see that? Holy fuck. Okay, excuse me, that was really important. I don't know why. The game struggles a bit over there, and I'm still looking over there, but it struggles less over here. It seems that the houses are more optimized or something, because these houses are fucking high detail. It's not like this is easy for the game or anything. Let's go back to the Red Rocket Dog. Back to what appears to, from what I've understood, the way the game laid out the Red Rocket, it's supposed to be your new home, because there's really everything, like the workbench and everything. Didn't think it would work like that, but there you go. I would have thought, you know, they'd make your house the default home in the game, but no. Start looking.
at Deathclaw's hand. How do I... Oh, yeah, right. How to put away the weapon in this game. Oh, that is just... That is cool. That is really, really cool. The only problem is the yaw. Look at this. When I'm not in my center, the yaw messes up completely. It's kind of like Ark. I actually showed a similar problem. Well, figure, Ark is a first-party VR. I demonstrated a similar problem with it. There we go. My center is back now. One thing I said I wanted to do, and I still haven't gotten around to. There we go. Now I can see you, boy. Good boy. What'd you find? How do I take it? Does it mean he picks it up and puts it in my inventory or something?
Hey.
Trade? Ah. That's cool. Okay, thanks for the hard hat. I didn't fucking realize. I guess the hard hat is an apparel? And I guess I can wear it. Let's see what else I can fucking wear. No. Oh my god. Raider chest piece, let's put it on. Raider leathers? Alright. Hopefully it makes me a little bit more resistant. Hopefully. Oh, but I walk like a... Guess what, dog? I can't level up using the Oculus Rift because I'm capturing video! Fucking bullshit. I hate this bullshit. There's a problem right now. It's only because I'm capturing video. So if you ever play this game, wow, with the Oculus Rift, you will not get this issue unless you're capturing video. When you capture video, there's a fucking window that overlays on the game's window. So check this out. I'm like, hey, the game's been wanting me to level up for a while, so let's take a look at it. And the Pip-Boy, Pip-Boy's like, go press T to level up. Press T to level up. I'm like, I don't want cap collector. So I grab my mouse to move it around. Doesn't work, because the overlay is interfering with it. Here's where I'm really fucking surprised. How did the game fuck this up? I don't know, because my mouse is working when I'm playing the game. I don't know why it's not working in the UI, but I know now that it's exactly that, because I'll show you why. If I go in here and then I move the mouse to the edge outside of that capture window, you see it's sort of responding momentarily there. That's such bullshit. So I'm gonna have to come back here later with the Vive and do this. Because with the Vive, I have nothing over my game window, so it would actually work. That sucks! I wanted to check out the level system, but that's okay, it's not the end of the fucking world. I did get to do a pretty cool room scale test with Deathclaw right there, that was pretty amazing. Daytime graphics, definitely not looking as good in Oculus. Again, I'm coming back to the reason why. It is most definitely that zoom, and nothing else. I will try to revisit these settings and show you a way to blast it as much as possible, because it really does make a huge ass fucking difference. See that, boy? We're back home, boy! We're back home, boy. Come on, boy! Aren't you happy we're back home? Imagine I just fucking walk into something. Walk into a fucking ghoul. It's still fucking beautiful. It still looks like a legitimate virtual reality game. It's got the same challenges as a game that's got a lot of detail in the graphics. Hey, and this is one really cool thing. If you watch part one of this Let's Play, I go over an issue that was rather regular, not super frequent,
rather regular. Or along some edges, you would see some blocking along one of the edges, only in one of my eyes. So sometimes on the left, sometimes on the right, you'd see these big black blocky edges along shadows. I have not seen that in part 5 with my latest graphics settings and the high resolution. And I have also not seen it with the CV1 in this part. And I've been playing for a while now. So good! That is one excellent riddance, because it really looks like shit. That problem looks like absolute shit. To have it gone is a very welcome thing. Well, I'm surprised. Aside from the death, my health cost from facing all those goals really wasn't too bad. I do have to make a mention to my friend Lord Estahoth. Thanks for the compliments on the shooting in part 3, by the way. I try to bring my A game whenever I can on video. Sometimes I'll lose my shit. When I say lose my shit, I don't mean get angry. I mean I panic. That's probably my worst thing as a video gamer. Is not like that I have one general flaw like bad aim or bad movement or bad coordination. I just panic. When I panic, I lose absolutely every single skill I may or may not have. It just goes away. It's gone. It's just... Might as well write me off. I'm gonna get killed some way. One or another, when I panic, I'm fucked, basically, is what I should say. I am fucked when I panic. Here's another reason why the daytime graphics really don't look as good as in the Vive. And I mean, there's a clear difference here. It's too fucking bright. It's actually a little too fucking bright. I don't know if I can adjust this in Vorpix. I do not think so. Oculus is a very fixed device when it comes to brightness, as they are trying to give everybody the same solution to work with and not have to fucking vary things game by game or have users just work with fucked up brightnesses, but it's too bright for the daytime. And it's just perfect for the nighttime. It looked a lot like the Vive during the nighttime, so there's your slight difference right there. Just a slight one. It does look beautiful, like I said earlier. It's just, you can't deny this. Sadly, I also mentioned that my video would not look as good because of the fact that I have to capture with the VR image distortion. And then I have to filter it out. And I'm using OBS to capture this, which is compressed, which is not like when I used to use DxStory in RGB, where the filter was barely noticeable. You're gonna notice it now. You're gonna notice the difference between part 5 and this one. Part 5 is probably the best looking part in the video so far. So, as I've returned home now, I'm gonna start thinking of moving towards the conclusion of this part. Not right away, because I know I wasted a lot of time doing the setting while recording it and everything, but 115 is already a distinct, definitive proof that the bug only happens with Steam VR. I'm actually blown the fuck away, dog. That with the Oculus Rift, this bug is nowhere to be found. I've been able to play the game for an hour and 15 minutes without any issues. Do not know if it's because the game is aware of my video card's memory and doesn't leak out of it or whatever, but I don't know. I don't know. There is no bug with the Oculus Rift. You can play indefinitely. Now, my logic for carrots, tomatoes, and shit is, I know there's been a nuclear attack and all, but if there's any of them left, wouldn't people have been growing shit in their backyard, maybe? And then in their backyard, there may be seeds left. What do you think, dog? Am I fucking stupid for thinking that? I mean, I'm gonna look. Is that a weed whacker? That's a weed whacker. That's funny. Just so believable, this world. Hey, I got my baseline test with the power lines. On the side of MSAA, this is pretty good. I can see the whole lines. I don't have segments of them missing. Almost, but not missing. So, the shimmer is really nowhere as bad as it was like in the first part of this Let's Play where it's just getting started. Can the chemistry station make carrots? No fucking way. In hell, in the universe, is that a possibility? Wow, there's a little bit of like steam or fog above the ground or something. There's definitely something going on here. Don't worry, boy. Don't worry. We're good. He's so funny. You got branches going through you, buddy. Here. I'll let you go, dog. Now, some people have criticized this dog here. I was talking about this in one of the earlier parts. I've had a Saint Bernard. I've dealt with having a big dog. And while they are very lovable animals, they're not very much the brightest. They seem to not be aware of how big they are and how much space they occupy. And they especially don't seem to be capable of realizing when they're blocking your way. So this little guy here, I got no problem with him. His game bugs to me are dog bugs. They're so similar to an actual dog. And the problems they will yield you. What'd you find? Where are you? Well, pick it up and bring it to me, okay? This guy teleports. My dog could not teleport, I'll tell you that for sure. But the thing about dogs is that, well, they'll block your way, they'll get in the way, they'll get excited, they'll do circles, they'll bump into things. Oh, you good doggy, good doggy, you brought it back. I remember bringing these. Has it done this before in the game and I didn't notice? Maybe? You brought it back, you're so cool. I like this NPC. I'm not much for criticizing it so far. Maybe later in the game I'll get pissed off at it. I don't know. I like that. I also like the fact they handled it so that it doesn't die, right? You stim it. If it gets in trouble, it'll not be able to help you anymore. You stim it if you want its help back, but at least it won't fucking die. So I think that's cool. I think that's fair. Because kind of hard to handle an NPC and then putting the burden on your shoulders of keeping it alive in the first place would be kind of a pain in the fuck, to be honest with you. It helps deal with the NPC's imperfections. He can be less than perfect and still not be too much of an encumbrance. See, I was hoping that this was going to contain something, but no. Let's keep doing backyards here. Hope I'm not going in circles. But I am looking attentively for vegetables and backyards.
Concord was bad news, huh, Mama? Seen one of those before?
No way. No way. Dog, how'd you get down here? Video game logic. Come on, tell me you got your shit. No, fuck. Instamash. Ooh. Oh, tell me the shit I can grow here. Sugar bombs? Purified water? Take just one. Okay, I got too much shit on me. Silver locket. Come on, tell me this place is gonna contain... Ooh. Gold bar. No. I'm leaving this shit down here. I'm gonna come back later for it. Oh, fucking... Take it. Man, it looks so real in here. This is unbelievable. This is absolutely fucking unbelievable. How real it looks in here. Snack and cakes. Shit, come on, tell me you have them. Oh? Shovel. I'm sure the shovel is for resources only. Fuck. Wouldn't that stop? I guess I can drink that. Alright, let's go and get rid of some stuff. Salisbury steak. Clean tents. Okay, this is shit I just dropped. Right away. Gold plated flip lighter. Need that right away. Oh.
Would you like some Danny Kay? I sure thought so.
I like don't want to leave here, boy. Because I thought this was going to be the spot where I was going to... Oh, you look so funny when you do that. I thought this was going to be the spot where we're going to find our vegetables. God damn it. Oh, I can sleep? Really? I didn't know I could sleep. Watch that it's all going to be in the goddamn safe. Ooh. I suck! I mean, pick it, bunghole! You look real in here. You look amazing. Dog, you look fucking amazing. Can I open this wooden crate? No, I just checked it. Alright then! Alright, alright. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna save while I'm in the root cellar. And we're gonna keep looking for shit like this, because I'm sure this is how I will end up finding carrots or potatoes or tomatoes or whatever the shit it is I'm supposed to grow up there. But I want to get that objective complete, and I also need some jet for our good old friend the synth, which I still haven't found either. So today it was a psycho holiday, and it was also an opportunity to do the psycho holiday with the Oculus Rift. So on that note, having enjoyed the psycho holiday, you did too, look at you, you're so happy, everybody's happy here, I shall leave you, and I thank you for watching part 6 of this Fallout 4 Let's Play using Vorpex, and this time, the Oculus Rift CV1 is the headset, and next time we'll be back with the HTC Vive. That's right, I'm going to be wearing that big blocky thing on my face next time. Mostly because I want to go level up, and I can't with the Oculus Rift because I'm capturing video. Yeah, but it's good to be able to tell people how to do this. So, Kid Havoc, it's time to go have some fun with your Oculus Rift CV1. Try out these settings. Tell me what you think. And that's it. Plays great. Plays really, really fucking great. I'll see you next time, folks. Thanks for watching.